Hey, I'm Mike and I'm here with Orbax. And we're gonna talk to you about torque.
Hi!
So, by now you guys know that torque is the ability for a force to cause rotation here. It depends on not only the force, but the distance between where the force acts and the pivot point. And in the last module, you guys looked at what happens if R and F are not perpendicular. So you guys came up with the idea that we can look at the force, but what's important is not the full force, just the component of the force that acts perpendicular to R. All right, so here we've got F, and what we're going to do is we're only going to take the perpendicular component. So that's going to be R times F sine theta, right? Okay, we want to show you a second method now that gets the same answer, but it's done a different way. Instead of looking at the component of F that's perpendicular to R, we're going to take a look at the line here that the force acts on, and we're going to look at the distance between the pivot point and the force. I'm going to call this R perpendicular. In the second method, what we do is we get the torque by calculating R perpendicular times the full force F. Now, we've got a right angle triangle in here. And so R perpendicular is going to be equal to R times sine theta. And we just use the full force. And there's our expression for torque.
They look like the same thing.
It's because they are the same thing. There we go. Two methods to calculate torque.
So torquey.